A grandmother from northern New South Wales says she's being offered a crumb from the state government after being banned from her son's funeral in Brisbane. It comes as the Deputy Premier takes an extraordinary swipe at the Prime Minister, suggesting the emotion he's shown over borders is a ploy to remove the Labor government at Queensland's election.
Another day of closed borders and the anguish still raw for many affected by it.
No, I just basically want to go to his funeral. But I'm not allowed to.
The border backlash growing by the day, stopping people like Elena Turner from entering Queensland to attend her son's funeral, who died earlier this week.
You know, we all have to put up with it. That's the rules now, and we can't do anything else.
Instead, the government held a press conference to talk about the upcoming election.
Today is the 8th anniversary of the horror budget that Campbell Newman brought down that sacked 14,000 people.
Stephen Miles took it further, saying the week of extraordinary attacks by Liberal ministers and the Prime Minister were all about Queensland's election.
Has he ever cried about the hundreds of people who died in aged care under his watch? Has he ever cried about the Ruby Princess? Does he cry right now for the tens of thousands of Australians who are stranded overseas? Scott Morrison thinks that getting Deb Frecklington elected might be one way to get his way, one way to get the borders open.
But the government is unlikely to change its stance on the state's restrictions. The Deputy Premier claiming Queensland's tough border policy is actually carrying the nation's economy.
Queensland's economy right now is propping up the national economy because we have not been impacted as much as the two other big states.
Saying this,
I've given exemptions for people in entertainment and film because that's bringing a lot of money into this state.
Really meant this.
Those industries have allowed people to keep their jobs.
What's unclear is whether Labor MP Duncan Pegg will keep his job. Pictures surfacing of him belly dancing at his 40th back in July, while dancing in clubs and pubs was banned.
A Labor MP belly dancing, but yet a mum can't go to her son's funeral.
Arrangements around funerals are some of the hardest, some of the most heartbreaking, the most distressing. We do provide people with exemptions.
Something else that isn't exempt is social distancing. At Doomben Racecourse, these punters may have backed a winner, but may not be celebrating for much longer. This footage bound to draw the attention of police.
Elena Turner has just been granted an exemption to drive to Queensland and view her son's body on Monday, but she will still not be allowed to attend her son's funeral. Elena will have to wear full PPE during the visit and then have to drive straight back to New South Wales afterwards. It seems heartless, but the government says these are the same restrictions that are in place in Tasmania, South Australia, the Northern Territory and WA. There were three new cases of coronavirus today, but thankfully they were all linked to people already in quarantine, and Queensland Health has expanded its list of places people with COVID-19 visited. Jonathan, they include Hungry Jack's and the Town Square Shopping Centre at Redbank Plains.
Comprehensive coverage to kick us off, Shannon. Thank you.